Moby Arena has seen its share of great teams and events, but as August turned the corner in 2001, magic was in the air. A talented and charismatic senior class was backed by a tradition of great volleyball. A community clad in green and gold filled the stands with excitement. Autumn nights in Moby mean one thing. Colorado State Volleyball is back. The season began with the University Park Holiday Inn Classic and their opening foe, the Arkansas Razorbacks. CSU showed its savvy from the beginning. Colorado State's Big Three had breakout nights. Angela Knopf, Courtney Cox, and Soraya Santos combined for 49 kills in the three-game win. The Rams went on to defeat nationally ranked Utah State in the championship game.
This year, our team has accomplished a lot of our goals. It was a great year, and I'm really proud of the way our team fought through the year and played well.
This team sets high goals. We don't settle for anything less than the best, and I think it should be expected. I think it's important to set your goals high so that you work hard enough to achieve those goals, and that's what this team did. I'm proud of them, and I think everyone worked hard enough to make ourselves in a position to achieve those goals.
I think that the passion we have for the game is unique to our program. I feel like at the beginning of each season, we decide what we want to accomplish and what we think we can accomplish. And then day in and day out, when we're lifting, when we're swimming, when we're running, when we're playing volleyball, I feel like that's in the forefront of our minds, is that goal.
The fans were out in force as the annual CU-CSU match would unfold. It featured a showdown between 20th-ranked CU and 8th-ranked Colorado State. There were great digs and long rallies, but in the end, the Rams' offense and great serving made the difference. Angela Knopf had 16 kills and drilled 4 jump serve aces in a remarkable performance. The Rams committed no serving errors, and the Buffs would go down in 3 games.
Anytime you play CU, it's huge, and anytime you beat CU, it's huge.
As my career here went on, I realized more and more that it's about pride, and to beat CU again and again. I mean, since my sophomore year, I've beat them every year, each time we played them.
Colorado State was now emerging as one of the top blocking teams in the nation, a surprising feat considering their moderate stature. The Rams were second in the nation in blocking, and the duo of Knopf and Knox were ranked in the nation's top 30.
We just have that amazing communication between us, whether we're passing or whether it's between Allie and her hitters. You know that you can count on that person standing right next to you on that court, and you never have a doubt in your mind, and I know that they feel the same way about everybody else on that court.
We know how each other clicks. We know what to say to get each other fired up. The girls, you know, we really like each other. We really enjoy being together.
They're really fun to work with because they have such great chemistry. You know, it's made it very rewarding to coach them because they get along like sisters.
Excitement was building as Fort Collins waited for the biggest weekend in Mountain West volleyball. Over 3,500 fans showed up to watch CSU battle the 19th-ranked Utah Utes. Allie Peckham decided early to backset, and it paid off. All-American Soraya Santos pounded 17 kills for one of her best matches of the year. Senior Emily Dodger chipped in for a 308 hitting efficiency. It was a team effort, resulting in a tough 3-game win. The next night, 5,480 fans were packed Moby as the 14th-ranked BYU Cougars came to town. The Rams were on a roll. Peckham dished one of the best matches of her career, and the Big Three delivered. Cox, Knopf, Santos showed why they were All-Americans. Soraya and Angela combined for 25 kills, while Courtney slammed 20 of her own to lead the team. When the smoke had cleared, CSU had pummeled the Cougars in 3, hitting a record 534. A mark good enough to earn Allie Peckham National Player of the Week. A fever surrounded the entire volleyball program. The Rams were on their way to the longest winning streak in CSU volleyball history. Fans were flocking to Mobile Arena in record numbers. Colorado State averaged 2,700 fans per match, ranking them fourth in the nation in attendance.
The fan support here is huge, and seeing it grow as much as it has since I've been here is so gratifying.
They are fans who love you no matter what. If you play well, you don't play well, they're there giving you a pat on your back. I have gotten some of the most amazing compliments from some fans that I've ever gotten in my life.
When I first came here and I saw the fans, and I was scared at first because I wanted to do good for them. I wanted to prove that I was good and I wanted to be part of the team.
The crowd is awesome, you guys. Thank you so much for coming out.
The highlight of the conference season came on a Friday in November when Colorado State would play at Provo, Utah. CSU had not won a regular season conference match in Provo since 1984, but this night would belong to the Rams. A regional TV audience watched Santos blast 14 kills by the Cougars. Her teammates pitched in for 62 kills in three games. The Rams dismantled the Cougars, clinching the regular season conference title and extending their winning streak to 20. The Mountain West Tournament proved tough for the Rams. A disappointing five-game loss to Utah would challenge their resolve in the postseason. The Rams visited third-ranked Stanford for an NCAA tournament tune-up. The Rams competed point for point with the eventual national champion despite their size disadvantage. Junior Michelle Knox and freshman Becky Saar had breakout matches. Becky hit 353 off the bench and Michelle hit 333 along with six blocks. The Rams lost the match, but walked away knowing they could compete with the best.
I think that was a great lesson for us, and I think that propelled us to step it up even further because we realized that, hey, we are beatable. Don't let it
beat you. The following Monday, the NCAA brackets were announced. For the third straight year, the Rams would be a first and second round host, this time facing three Big 12 opponents.
Whenever you go into NCAAs, it's like a whole new attitude. Each team takes on a whole new attitude, and that attitude is, if we lose this, we are done. Our season is done.
Their first opponent would be the Baylor Bears and their All-American candidate, Stevie Nicholas. The Rams came out tough, winning the first game behind the middle attack of Knopf and Knox. But Baylor and Nicholas banged their way back, winning game two. Showing poise and confidence, Colorado State's balanced attack won the next two games, creating a matchup with the Colorado Buffaloes for the second straight year.
One more time.
The CU-CSU volleyball rivalry was known as one of the fiercest in college volleyball, and this match would not disappoint. In the first game, CSU led most of the way, but crucial plays gave CU a 30-28 victory. Then the Rams, feeding off the nearly 4,000 rowdy fans, won the next two games and seemed in control, but Colorado was not ready to quit. They edged out the fourth game and jumped to an early lead in the fifth. Then the Rams' great senior class refused to let their final season end.
Being down 10-5 was almost near impossible. I swear if you did it like 20 times, maybe once out of 20, you could possibly win that.
There's a point in my mind where I realized, you know, if we don't turn this around, our season's going to be over, my career's going to be over, and I didn't want that to happen.
We just knew that we didn't want our season to be over. We wanted to go to the Sweet 16, and we knew it was do or die.
I was on the bench at this moment when we were down, and I was about to go back in, and I said to myself, you know what, it isn't over.
The score was 13-10 when senior Soraya Santos went back to serve.
I remember it was my turn to serve, and he told me to jump serve, and my legs were shaking, and I was just like, I don't want to do this.
Soraya pounded a jump serve ace, then served down two more to knot it at 13. All 4,000 fans were on their feet when a pair of Cox kills put the Rams ahead. Once the 16th point was scored, it was pure pandemonium. The Rams would advance to the Sweet 16 in one of the greatest matches ever played in Mobile Arena. It's my life. It's my life. Colorado State moved on to Lincoln, Nebraska. A sold-out crowd was on hand as the Rams shocked the Huskers, winning the first game 31-29. Nebraska battled back to win games 2 and 3. CSU fought like champions. Game 4 saw the Rams lead for most of the game, but a late Husker rally tied it at 26. From that point on, it was a battle, thrilling the 4,200 fans in attendance. The Huskers finally won, an emotional 36-34 decision, ending the Rams' remarkable season.
It was very hard. It was extremely disappointing for those of us seniors that knew it was our last game and our last opportunity to compete at this level. However, I still think there was a lot of pride. I felt really proud of ourselves. I felt really proud of my teammates.
College volleyball has rarely seen a finer group of players or a greater love affair with the community. The 2001 season marked the end of the careers of six great players, but the tradition of Colorado State volleyball lives on.
I think that they're definitely going to make it far, and they're going to surprise a lot of people, and they're going to continue to put CSU name out there in the volleyball world as one of the powerhouses.
Now, CSU volleyball will be good. It just takes a little bit of time to build that up. You've got to get some people some playing experience and get them out there swinging and get them out playing under the lights. Once we do that, we're going to be very good again.
They are going to be so good. I think Grand Volleyball has such a bright future.
When I first came here, just watching the players, I've learned so much about the game, and I know that they're doing the same thing. Just watching the seniors, how hard we work.
I think that the quality and the knowledge of our coaching staff can take any group far. But I also know that the girls in the team, and I know how hard they work, and I know how athletically talented they are.
People think that it's going to be tough after this. It's not, because these girls are outstanding. They're such great athletes, and they're going to do so well.
On an emotional night in November, Colorado State said goodbye to six seniors whose careers have been a catalyst to the recent success of the CSU program. Their talent, class, and great chemistry has set an example of what a team can accomplish when they selflessly work together to achieve their goals.
It was a special moment. You know, there is another memory, good memory, that it's gonna be in my mind, and just being able to have my family there, and you know, Allie's family was there too. We're from another country, and just being able to have her family with us in a night so special like that one was, it was just so great. I was crying, and senior night was great. You know, just the seniors, we're all there. Our last match, you know, the regular season, and they made it so special.
It's an incredible, overwhelming experience to step out on the court, you know, twice a week for a match and have them read your name and step forward and wave to a crowd of thousands of people that really care about you and that know you and that want to know you and that appreciate what you're passionate about and they appreciate how you perform.
It was different emotions going through my head. It was elation, and then it was a moment of sadness and looking back at everything that I'd accomplished and everything that I'd been through with these girls and with Tom and with Carrie and Andy. And I sat there and I told myself, I want to savor this. I want to savor this forever.
The emotion that was going through my head most was happiness. I looked around and I saw the great support we had from community, from everyone's families. And I took a moment just to take a mental picture of it all, because it's times like that that you're going to remember, and I know that I'm going to take that experience with me for the rest of my life.
CSU is
Senior night was pretty emotional for me. It was actually a senior week, it seemed like, for me. I cried every day that whole week, just thinking about how this season was coming to an end. It was really hard to have to say goodbye. It was really emotional, really sad, and it's going to be hard to not be playing with these girls ever again.
Senior night was the best experience I think I've had. I went through every emotion from being totally excited to realizing this was my last home game. And I just tried to soak up as much time as I can because it's been such a huge blessing for me to play here.
Emily Darker's solid leadership made major contributions in her career. As an outside hitter, she finished her season with over 200 kills. A Debbie Murphy Award winner, she was respected by players and coaches alike. Emily was named team captain in 2001.
Emily Darker is, from a coach's standpoint, the best leader I've ever seen, period. I mean, she is a great leader on the court and off the court, great maturity, and has been a glue that's helped make this team what it is today.
Defensive specialist Kelly Kerr is the smallest in the class, but has the biggest heart. Kelly finishes her career as the most efficient serve receiver on the team.
Kelly Kerr has incredible energy. Great personality, someone that you know is going to try to do everything in her power to win when she gets out on the court.
Setter Allie Peckham is one of the most prolific setters to play for the green and gold. In her 3 years as a starter, she tallied 4,845 assists, and her season team hitting percentages ranked first, second, and 10th in school history. The two-time conference setter of the year carries an amazing 89-12 record as a starter.
Allison Peckham started for this team for 3 years and was the quarterback of this team and really made the people around her better. Was able to distribute the ball evenly, keep the other teams guessing, and I think that one of her legacies is that we've had nationally ranked hitting percentages in this program for the past 2 years, and that's attributed to her.
Outside hitter Courtney Cox has thrilled the Moby faithful for 4 years with her great strength and jumping ability. The three-time All-Conference selection and 2000 All-American ranks fifth all-time in kills for CSU, notching over 1,500. Coupled with her nearly 300 blocks, she has been a force on the left side for her entire career.
Courtney Cox is a dynamic athlete. She's always been somebody that's really fun to watch because of her jumping ability and her arm swing. She's someone that turns it on against the best competition. And when we went to war every night with this team, when we're playing in the tough situations against the good teams, we wanted Courtney to get the ball because we knew she was going to swing at it and put it away.
Right side hitter Soraya Santos had the eye of an eagle and a whip on her shoulder. Santos punished her opponents every night, hitting a variety of sets. She was the most efficient all-around player for the Rams, finishing in the top three in five statistical categories. Soraya's play captured the nation's attention as she garnered All-American honors in 2001.
Soraya Santos is an intense player with a great arm swing, with great range, and really grew as an athlete in this program to where she was physically dominant as well as being a great volleyball player.
Few players in Ram history will match the accomplishments of Angela Knopf. She was an ambassador off the court and a warrior on the court. The two-time AVCA All-American is first in hitting percentage, first in aces, and first in blocks in the CSU record books. She is the all-time leader in hitting percentage and ranked first in the nation most of 2001. In fact, her 393 career mark will rank her eighth in NCAA history.
Angela Knopf, you cannot say enough about her. She's the best volleyball player that I've seen. She was able to maximize her own physical ability and use her uncanny gamesmanship to really beat any opponent, regardless of their size or ability or whatever. And I think that Angela will go down as one of the best volleyball players ever to play here.
It seems like only yesterday when these six players came out of high school wide-eyed and innocent. Their chemistry, camaraderie, and hard work have led them to record-breaking years. 48 straight weeks in the top 25 and three straight top 16 appearances. Their time under the lights in Moby may be over, but these six athletes have helped carve a new future for CSU volleyball.
This group has accomplished a number of milestones, and they've gone through a lot of things together that have really set them apart from other groups. You know, they beat the number one team in the nation on national TV. They've been in the Sweet 16 3 years in a row. They've been ranked as high as third in the nation. They've been in the top 10 for 3 years. They just, you know, probably set themselves apart as being one of the most successful teams, not just volleyball at CSU, but one of the most successful teams of any sport at this school. And so I think they can take that with them, and that's going to be theirs for the rest of their lives.